meeting. We're gonna have a great time together. We got a lot of information, the perfect situation. We're gonna have a good time. And whether you drove down the street just to get here, took a train, a plane, a bus, you're gonna find it's worth your while to spend this time with us. It's gonna be a good, good morning. A good, good morning meeting. We're gonna have a great time today.
Hi, I'm Kim Meltzer, your Clinton Township Clerk. I'm honored to be here with our Fire Chief, Michael Phy. Thank you for being with us today, Mike.
Welcome.
How are you?
Good.
Everything,
how are you doing?
I'm good. How's everything going over in the fire department?
Very good.
Good.
Very good.
I know you guys are super busy.
Yes.
So I appreciate you taking time out of your day to talk about this really important idea and implementation that's already implemented in over almost 300 households in Clinton Township, and that is the residential lockbox program. And residents can see here, these are two types of lockboxes. And what I'd like to explain to the residents, and have you explain, I should say, is what are these residential lockboxes used for? Why might people be interested in making a purchase to get one? And let's start out with that question, I guess.
Okay. The residential locks, residential lock box.
It
program,
is a tongue twister.
Yep. Like you said, it's been in existence in Clinton Township for about 8 years now. And what it is a program where we can access a residential home when that person isn't home, or if they, for instance, become incapacitated and can't make it to the door. And it allows us access using their own house key to get inside and take care of whatever emergency or issue that's going on without causing any damage to the property itself. The lockbox is a very sturdy metal box. There's several different styles, and we actually push two different styles in Clinton Township. But the idea of it is that is it a secure system where only the firemen can access your key at your house to make entry to your house.
So why don't you tell us how that works? There's this type here. Both require a key that the fire department has,
yes,
to access this, and then the homeowner has to put their key inside here. So there's one that goes, this one goes over the door, and this one goes on the handle, is that?
That is correct.
Okay, and which one is more preferred in, by you guys? Do you have a preference?
We actually prefer the over the door.
Okay.
Because it is less conspicuous, and it, even though the we allow both and we condone or we support both of these types, it just we try to stay away from the over the door handle.
Yeah,
this is the style that you would see for real estate type of applications, and we kind of just feel that it might make your house appear as if it's vacant, and we really don't want that. We want something smaller. We'd like something smaller over the door, and really it can't be seen from the street.
Right. And that one seems more aesthetically appealing as well, I would think. I'd rather have that, I would think, too. But there are both versions that you utilize in the township,
yes,
and you don't have any problems with them. They're both equally convenient for you to access and get the keys for the residents.
Yes.
So why would people have a lockbox? And I mean, I know there's an obvious reason so you can get in, but who are the type of people that would want one of these? Is it an everyday person? Is it more of a senior citizen that's kind of like the snowbirds that go away for a while? But, or is it, everyday people that come and go every day that I would think could capitalize on this and want it as well.
Yes, it's basically everybody could benefit from this program. Most of our clients right now seem to be the elderly or people with some medical conditions that really a lot of people that have fall issues that can't make it to the door and let the fire department or emergency services in. But that's not all the access to the home or the lockbox can be used for. It also can be used for if you have a fire alarm in your house and you're not home, or your smoke detector is going off and your neighbor hears it and they call it in. This allows us access to your home without causing any damage to your doors, your door jams, glass, screen doors, anything like that, because we can just merely use a key and get into your house.
So how would somebody go about making this purchase? Is this something they find in the stores, or is there a location specific that you guys have a relationship with?
Yes, it's specific. It's a company called Roper, R-O-P-E-R, and I'm sure we're going to be...
We'll put that name on the screen. We'll put there's a website, there's a phone number. We'll have that scrolling along. And then I think you also mentioned that information is on our ClintonTownship.com website under the fire department tab. You guys have that listed on your homepage.
That's correct. The instructions, how to order, as Ms. Meltzer said, there's several ways. You can do it online. You can do it through a 1-800 number.
Well, the important thing is there's two options. And if they need help, they can contact the township offices. If they have any questions, we can help them and refer them to the fire department.
Yes.
Whatever questions they might have before they want to make their purchase. But if they were to call using that 1-800 number, they're very helpful. I did contact that the number, and I did go on their website, so it's, you know, you can see different options. The cost is nominal. Calculated was $34.45, and that included the shipping. Actually, the cost was $27.95 with $6.50 shipping, so that came to $34.45. Now, that price could change over time, but that's kind of the area, and you know what you're talking about in terms of expending those dollars. It's not a lot for that convenience, and that would, you know, I know that the fire department, you guys have come to my house when my house was struck by lightning. You guys are very considerate of the property. And,
yes.
But if you have to get in that house and it's locked, you're going to have to break something. And so this eliminates that scenario. So I think it's well worth the
$34.45. Here's where the keys are locked up right here. Only we have access to it. So when it's turned on, we have a code that only we can access the key to get us into the home. So here's how we access it. It's locked up through a code. So only we can get it. Yeah, there's a different code for everybody. It's lock it, because it's the last four of everybody's home. So that's basically it. And then this is the key we use for the box right here.
There we go.
The homeowner's key is in this locked up, so this is the key that they give us that we put in there.
I see.
Yeah. So it goes in there. Once we have access to it, now we can access the home.
That's good. This goes down. Zip over. Cool. Very nice. Good. Very good.
As you see, the keys are very secure in both parts of the system, whether they're in the truck, in the safe itself, or on the residence door. It's very simple for us to access the key in an emergency or even in a non-emergency. And then it's also very easy to access the key box on the door to gain access. And something that we should mention too is that this is a one-time fee. There's no monthly fee for maintenance on these. You purchase the product, it comes shipped right to your home. You call the fire station. We send a crew out, and our crew puts your key in that box for you. And we are the only ones that can get in that box.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome. And when I talked to them, they said it's a two-day priority mail. So you call, and you'll get it within a couple days, she said. So that's a pretty quick turnaround for people. And again, this is a great opportunity. She also said Sterling Heights just launched this program, and they've had quite a increase in demand for this. So, but they really love Clinton Township because we have almost 300 residents that yep. have already acquired this. And actually, I see no reason why I shouldn't have one as well.
I really think that this is a great program, and Anybody, any age, anybody that has residential property, even some apartment units have taken advantage of this. Not apartment units, I should say, but units within an apartment mm-hmm. With personnel that have medical issues. A lot of our clients have medical issues, or they're elderly, but that, like we said, that is not the only application for this. Anybody that, such as yourself, who might have something going on at their home where they want to allow us access but not to damage their property further, this is perfect.
Right. So when you guys are called out, do you know ahead of time that you have a key for this particular home then? You, obviously, it's set up through you guys, so I think you'd have that information.
Yes.
How does that work?
When we are dispatched, the warning or the alert goes to our computer laptops in our trucks. Mm-hmm. So when we receive the call, it'll say lockbox or key box, and it'll give the location, whether it's the front door, your side door, your back door, whatever it might be, we have that information as a warning on our screen. So. And our guys, our personnel are always looking to make sure that people don't have a lock. They're making sure that people may have a lockbox of a different style that we're not even aware of.
Okay.
And that allows our guys to be aware of this, to maybe call dispatch and get additional information. Such as a key code or something, but we're trying to get away from those private key boxes outside of this particular program because we still do have some of those out there.
Yeah, well, I would think you'd have to know in order for it to be a benefit. That way you can, you know, do the least amount of damage.
Right.
But I just want to really reiterate that I know the Clinton Township Fire Department firsthand respects the property as they're coming out, and even if there is a fire, they're still trying to do all they can to get that fire out as fast as they can, but and maintain the integrity of the building as well, so in that private property. So it's really important because it's traumatic enough to go through,
right.
To have additional losses that could be mitigated if there's just some careful, you know, approach. I think it's great, and so I really appreciate that about the Clinton Township Fire Department. Well, I think there's other issues with other communities looking at this. I think they're going to look at what Clinton Township is doing, and I think we make a great benchmark for other communities. And I hope that those that are watching today will take advantage of this. Give us a call or call that 1-800 number or go to the website. And thank you for your time and for listening. And Mike, thank you so much for your time.
Thank
and
you.
We thank the fire department for all you do for us.
Thanks.